When you first open Dreamweaver, you'll see a welcome screen. Yours might look different if you have a different version of Dreamweaver. Notice that Dreamweaver can create several different types of web documents. We want to create an HTML web page, so we'll go ahead and select HTML document. And this creates a new HTML document. Remember, a web page is basically just a text document that uses HTML code. So first of all, we see two main windows in the center of the screen. And this is our split view. If you don't see this view, go up to the top bar and click on Split. On the bottom, we have the code view. This is our HTML code. And at the top, we have a live preview of what your finished web page will look like. Basically, what happens is that your web browser reads this HTML code and then turns it into the final web page. You can also change your view. If you click on Code, you'll see just the code view. Or if you click on Live, you'll see just the live view. But we want to see both, so we'll go back to split view. Now, Dreamweaver is what you would call a WYSIWYG editor. WYSIWYG is just an acronym, WYSIWYG, and this stands for what you see is what you get. And this doesn't make such a difference in live view, but if I click and change this to design view, I can actually type whatever I want, and Dreamweaver automatically turns it into HTML code in the code view. Now let's say I want to make something bold. Just select the word you want, and then use the standard keyboard shortcut. On Windows, it's Control B. On Mac, it's Command B. And Dreamweaver automatically adds the HTML tags we need to make that bold. Next, we're going to add an image. But before we do that, there's a few steps we need to do. First, we're going to save our work. In general, it's really important to save when working in multimedia. In Dreamweaver, it's especially important to save before adding any images to your web page. So go to the File menu and choose Save. I'm going to save it into this intro folder. Generally, it's a good idea to create a new folder and then put all your pages for a website into that folder. Give it a name and click Save. The other thing we need to do is find some images and put them in the same folder with our HTML document. So I've switched over to Windows. If you're on a Mac, your view might look a little different. And I have two windows here. I have this folder that has my image in it, and then I have this other folder that has my HTML page. So I want to use this image, westminster.png, in my web page. So I'll copy it, and then paste it into this folder with my HTML page. You could also just drag and drop, but then that will probably move it from the old location to the new one, and you may not want to do that. So now that I have an image in the same folder as my HTML page, I'll switch back to Dreamweaver. Now let's add the image to our web page. Go to the Insert menu and choose Image. Find the image that you want. Click OK. And Dreamweaver inserts the image into our web page. If you look at the code view, you'll see that a special IMG tag has been added. And this is the source code for our image. It basically tells the web browser where to find the image you want to display. Lastly, let's change the background color of this page. Go to your design view and click somewhere on the white background. Now go to the window menu and select the properties panel. And this panel changes based on whatever you have selected. To set a background color, click on the button that says Page Properties. And a window pops up giving us some different properties we can set. We want to change the appearance of this web page. And we have two options, Appearance CSS and Appearance HTML. The modern way to control the appearance of a web page is to use CSS. So make sure that option is selected. And from there, you can select a background color. I'll go with a nice blue. And then click OK when you're done. But now the background color is blue, but the black text is a little hard to see. So I'll set the text color to white. Click on Page Properties again, and then for text color, choose a white. Click OK, and my text is white. And if we go back to the code view, you'll see that Dreamweaver added some CSS code. It looks different than HTML because it's used to control the styling of the page, whereas HTML is used to create the content. That's it for now, but feel free to play around. That's really the best way to learn multimedia software.